हुमायूज टूम, मकबरा हुमायूं, इज द टूम ऑफ द मुगल एम्परर हुमायूं इन दिल्ली, इंडिया। द टूम वॉज डिक्लेयर्ड अ यूनेस्को वर्ल्ड हेरिटेज साइट इन 1993। द टूम वॉज कमीशन बाय हुमायूं फर्स्ट वाइफ एंड चीफ कंसोर्ट एक्सप्रेस बेगा बेगम, ऑल्सो नोन एज हाजी बेगम, इन 1569-70। द टूम वॉज डिजाइन बाय मीरक मिर्जा ग्यास, अ पर्शियन आर्किटेक्ट। It was the first garden tomb on the Indian subcontinent. It was also the first structure to use red sandstone at such scale. The building was first to use its unique combination of red sandstone and white marble and include several elements of Indian architecture like the small canopies or chhatris surrounding the central dome, popular in Rajasthani architecture, and were originally covered with blue lines. It represented a leap in Mughal architecture, and together with its accomplished Charbagh garden, typical of Persian garden but never seen before in India, it set a precedent for subsequent Mughal architecture. Underneath this white dome, in an domed chamber, hujra, lies the central octagonal sepulchre. The burial chamber contains a single cenotaph, that of the second Mughal emperor, Humayun, aligned on the north-south axis as per Islamic tradition, wherein the head is placed to the north while the face is turned sideways toward Mecca. The vaulted chambers contain the cenotaph of other family members. The sex of each occupant is marked by a simple carved symbol. A box of writing instrument indicate male and a writing slate indicate female. The name is not inscribed. Ceiling of the entrance dome of Humayun's tomb. The symbolically cut out mihrab facing west or Mecca over the marble lattice jali screen. The burial technique along with the petra dura, a marble and even stone inlay ornamentation in numerous geometrical and arabesque patterns seen all around the facade is an important legacy of the Indo-Islamic architecture and flourished in many later mausolea of the Mughal Empire. Like the Taj Mahal, where again we find twin cenotaphs and exquisite petra dura craftsmanship. The entire tomb and the garden is enclosed within high rubble walls on three sides. The fourth side was meant to be River Yamuna, which has since shifted course away from the structure. It has two double-story entrances, the west gate which is used now, while the south gate which was used during Mughal era now remain closed. Tomb and mosaic of Isa Khan. Several monuments dot the pathways leading up to the tomb enclosure from the main entrance in the west. Prominent among them is the one that predates the main tomb itself by 20 years, constructed in 1547 CE. It is the tomb complex of Isa Khan Niazi, an Afghan noble in Sher Shah Suri's court of the Suri dynasty, who fought against the Mughals. The octagonal tomb is positioned within an octagonal garden which was built during his own lifetime and the region of Islam Shah Suri, son of Sher Shah. It later served as a burial place for the entire family of Isa Khan. Baba's tomb. Towards the southeast corner, within the Chabag, lies a tomb known as Naika Gumbad or Baba's tomb. Belonging to Royal Baba, it is datable to 1590-91 CE through an inscription found inside. Its proximity to the main tomb and the fact that it is the only other structure within the main tomb complex suggests its importance. However, there are no inscriptions suggesting as to who is interred therein. The name Baba's tomb is the local name of the structure, hence still in use.